Welcome back to Spell Tutorial Services. Today we're going to look at the application of the law of signs. We have a question above. You are a city worker that has to secure a leaning pole. The pole is 25 feet tall and is leaning at an angle of 100 degrees. You decide to secure the top of the pole with a guy wire, creating an angle of 50 degrees with the ground. How much guy wire do you need to complete the job? All right, well, the problem tells us that we have a pole that's leaning at 100 degrees, so let's draw a pole. This here's the 100 degrees, and we'll say this here is our pole. It tells us that the pole is 25 feet, and we're going to secure a guy wire from the top of the pole and angle it to the ground. All right, this here is the guy wire. We don't know the length of the guy wire, so we'll just label that X. And we're also told that the angle that it creates with the ground is 50 degrees. All right, with these facts, we're going to use the law of sine to figure out the length of side X. Well, we're going to start off by taking the sine of 50. And we're going to divide that by its opposite side, which has a length of 25. We're going to set that equal to the sine of 100, and we're going to divide that by the unknown length x. First step is to cross multiply, so I have x sine 50 is equal to 25 times the sine of 100. Trying to solve for x, so I need to isolate x by dividing both sides by the sine of 50. In doing so, the sine of 50 over the sine of 50 evaluates down to 1, and I'm left with x is equal to 25 times the sine of 100 divided by the sine of 50. When I evaluate that, we find out that x is approximately 32.14 feet. So that's how much guy wire we need to make sure that we have on the truck before we start this job to secure that pole. That sums it up for this video from Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the same name, Speller Tutorial. Thank you again for watching.